us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the
Amen.
Lord.
Amen. Bethlehem.
Just yes, I am.
Let's do it again.
Bethlehem.
Oh, yes, I am.
Amen. Let's have a word of prayer. Father God, we come right now. We commit our hearts and our minds unto you, Lord, for this time, Lord. It's not about the day that I had. It's not about maybe the frustration in my mind, but this time is about you, Father. So, Father, we want to take our day off, whether it was good or bad. We want to commit our hearts and our minds unto you that yes. you may be glorified yes. in our lives yes. and that we might be more like Christ yes. for heaven
yes,
met
yes,
tonight, Father. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And praise the Lord. Yes, go ahead and give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. It's always good to be in the household of the Lord. Cold on the outside, but warm on the inside. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, this Wednesday night, we're going to begin the series I entitled Purity for a New Year. Purity for a New Year. And we're going to end this time, prayerfully, if it's the Lord's will, on Thursday, December the 31st. So we're going to cancel that Wednesday and we're going to come on Thursday and have our watch service. And we're going to end with a message entitled A Pure Devotion to Christ, to which is what we want to go into next year with, a pure devotion to Christ. But these next 3 weeks we're going to look at a message entitled Purified by the Pure Spiritual Milk, Prayer for Purity in the World, and the Purity of the Age. And let's go ahead and look at what we're going to be talking about tonight. When I talk about purity, this is a good time to talk about, go back to the other. It's a good time to talk about New Year's resolutions. New Year's resolutions. Now, some don't think that that is a spiritual concept, but it can be if you allow your resolutions to be spiritual. But I thought this was interesting, some interesting information about New Year's resolutions. And again, I want to allow this time, or this time on purity, to allow the Holy Spirit to begin to put things in our hearts and our minds that he wants to work on this next year. But just interesting facts, 40 to 45% of American adults makes one or more resolution each year. Some interesting resolutions that are made to lose weight. And to lose weight is a tremendous resolution, especially if you're not at your healthy weight. One of my favorite shows is The Biggest Loser. And it's amazing, as these people drop their weight, they drop in medicines and prescriptions and all of that, and they go through certain things because their body's not a good, healthy weight. And for the believer, the body is what?
Temple.
The body is the temple. You think that we should take care of our temple?
Oh, yeah. Man,
I think we should. I really wish that we would treat our temple the way we treat some of the furniture within the church.
Yeah.
As holy and set apart and sanctified. And mm-hmm. wish we would treat some of the people as holy and sanctified as that. But exercise, of course, stop smoking. There's another good one. I think they said, I forgot the statistic. I think they said something like 40 chemicals that you can't put up under your kitchen counters in the same. And you put that kind of stuff in your temple, you think that's a big problem. I think that's a big, and I think it's spiritual to not smoke, don't you?
Amen.
Though people say, don't say in a word that thou shalt not smoke. But also don't say thou shalt not drink bleach either. Yeah. We got the common sense. But all of this stuff is good for the body, the temple. Some people say, well, but if I make this resolution, I won't keep it no way. Statistics say that what? For the following, it shows that many resolutions are maintained as the time goes on. For the first week, 75% keep their resolutions. 2 weeks, 71%. After a month, 69%. After 6 months, 46% keep their resolution. I think that's a good percentage. Half. Oh, yeah. Half, almost half. Which shows us really, if you don't set goals to become a better you, both in the physical and spiritual realm, then you'll get what you set. Nothing.
That's right.
You get nothing. But if you allow the Spirit to put certain things upon your hearts and your minds and say, okay, within this next year I want to be purified, then you will be a better person. Amen. You'll be a more healthier person. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So this series on purity is to get us in the mindset to allow the Holy Spirit of God, and we're going to have spiritual resolutions that God will work on and identify certain areas in our lives that we may change for this next year. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Okay? So let's get into our first message tonight. The message tonight is Obey Your Thirst. Subtitle. So Obey Your Thirst. And we're going to be looking at 1 Peter 2, 1 through 3. And let's read this together on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Therefore, rid yourselves of all malice and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. Like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk, so that it may grow up in your salvation.
Now that you have tasted the Lord is good.
Amen. Tonight, we're going to learn and look at, as Reverend Ford pushed that button. I want you to do three things tonight. I want you to obey your throw, obey your thirst, and obey your taste. Obey your throw as in read. Obey your thirst and obey your taste. And Christians should crave a purified lifestyle in the new year. Say to your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
This next year.
This next year.
I won't be the same.
I won't be the same.
I'm going to change.
I'm going to change.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Well, obey your thirst. First point. Obey the throw. The text says, therefore, rid yourself of all malice. You want some spiritual resolutions? Deceit. What else?
Hypocrisy.
Hypocrisy.
Envy.
Envy.
Slander of every kind.
And slander of every kind. I think for a Christian, this is a great spiritual resolution. That's the Holy Spirit lays upon your heart that you say that this next year that I'm going to rid my life of some things. And you know, things are
another calm on the sea, but what we need is a special word that will burn within.